say, Ma, he said he coming. I said, Ma, he said he coming. I'm gonna stay here till you come, Ma. She tapped me again. She said, Junior, come on inside now. He ain't coming. Your dad ain't even in town. I said, Mama, I looked up. I said, Mama, what's the difference between a daddy and a father? She said, fall on your knees and let me teach you what a father is. I fell in love with a voice. I fell in love with a connection that I would never separate from. I heard a voice once explain to me what a father is. God whispered to me, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I am the beginning and the end. I am Alpha and Omega. And if you find yourself believing in my son, then eternity is promised to you.
You're right.
Then I said, well, Mama, I said, well, who gonna teach me how to work out? I said, who gonna be there for my football games? Will I ever see my daddy there? I fell in love with a voice. Then I fell in love with pain. I fell in love with how, what I could make my body feel like. And still get up the next day and do it again. And do it again. And do it again. Then I looked at my mom one day, my mom had two black eyes. And I said, Mama, who did that? Then my mama came to me and said, I can't have you in the house no longer. The man I'm with don't like you in the house. So I'm gonna have to move you to the garage. I said, Mama, you sure you wanna put me in the garage? I said, Mama, you can't put me in the garage because I'm lonely. I said, so what does that do to me, Mama, if you put me in the garage by myself? She said, Junior, that's all we got right now. I said, Mama, you know what? If it'll make you happy, then I'll go. But in that garage, I built up something. I turned my mind into a physically walking machine. To where nothing that man ever did to me, nothing that nobody ever said about me, will ever stop me from chasing what I'm trying to get done. Then my mama come down and she grabbed me one last time and she said, Junior, I really need to talk to you. I said, Mama, what's next? It can't get no worse than this. She said, I can't feed you no more, Junior. I said, Mama, what you mean you can't feed me? I don't eat but one time a day anyway. She said, Junior, I need that for your brothers and sisters. She said, I'm gonna have to give you away. She said, go stay with your great grandma for 2 years and hopefully come back to me. I said, Mama, you sure? You sure you wanna give me away? I said, Mama, I don't gotta eat. I ain't gotta eat. I said, I'll figure it out. I said, Mama, I promise you we'll figure it out. She said, Junior, I can't figure it out. She sent me away. She called me back in the ninth grade and said, Junior, I made enough money now, you can come back home. A year later, she said, I got to give you back away again. She said, because I done hit my last leg. She said, we moving now. I said, Mama, I can't move. She said, you got to move. I said, Mama, I can't. She said, why? I said, Mama, because I'm trusting the same voice that I heard when I was 10 years old. And that voice don't say what you said. You saying go, that voice say stay. I made up my mind.